Having heard of your repentance and your faith, we now baptise you, Barrington, in the name of God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. Father, as we baptise Barrington in water, we ask you now to baptise him and fill him and flood him with your Holy Spirit in Jesus' name. Amen.
There's a brilliant story around New Year's Eve. This is probably encouragement for Mr. Wilson and his website. There was a lady came to the New Year's Eve meeting from Northampton. And the reason she came was that she couldn't find an appropriate Christmas Eve meeting that she wanted to go to in her local area. New Year's Eve. They were all sort of like discos and parties, and that wasn't what she wanted. So she went onto the internet, found Green Baptist Church, saw that we were doing a New Year's Eve worship celebration type event, got in her car, drove down from Northampton and stayed, enjoyed it, then drove home again. How cool is that, eh? It's got brilliant testimony to the work that Andy's doing in the website as well. So
I was on this, I went to the Holy Spirit Day yesterday for Ballistic. I don't normally go to Ballistic, though I'm actually teaching them next week. And I want to do two things. I want to encourage you to pray for our young people here. I mean, it's an extraordinary thing to have 20 of them together for the day yesterday. Worshipping God, praying together, having God speaking to them. It was a really dynamic environment. It was a superb day. And we are so privileged to see the work that God is doing among young people here as part of our church family. So I want you to give thanks to God for them, but I want you to pray for them, because many of them are in difficult contexts, in their schools, some of them in their families. Let's pray for them to be faithful to God, to see the God stuff through in their situations. And these are people who in the years to come, some of them, we were prophesying over some yesterday, going to be significant Christian leaders in times to come. Let's pray for them now that all of these things that they're learning will be rooted in their lives. They will stand for God and make a difference for God in the future. I want to encourage you to do that, to thank God for all that he's been doing and for this group of people. We have around 30 young people in Ballistic. They're not all here every week, but there are 30 teenagers that come to the Ballistic group, which is teaching, worship, prayer, and they come. Most of them come most weeks. I'm going to interview Leslie today. I've known Leslie quite a long time. When did you first become a Christian, Leslie?
When I was 15.
Now, some of your visitors here may not know that we're actually married. One of the questions that people might like to ask is, when did you meet your husband?
I went to an all-girls school, and that's where I met my husband.
If you want to find out how that happens, you'll have to ask later on. I too went to an all-girls school for a year. If you want to know how that happened, you'll have to ask later on. Okay, thank you very much indeed.
It is of supreme importance
that we get our image of Jesus
right. His conversation was about the finer things in life.
Doe, sheep, pig farming, wise virgins.
He never dabbled with controversy.
He just claimed to be the Son of God.
Jesus never upset anyone by his language.
Except priests, Pharisees, pigeon sellers, executioners, and wealthy young men.
He was respected in religious circles.
We wanted to lynch him after his first sermon.
Jesus was a man among men
and women.
He was a man of God.
He was the Son of God.
It is of supreme importance
that you get our image of Jesus
right.
Having heard of your repentance and your faith, we now baptise you, John, in the name of God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit.
£5. Let's start this. Come on, £5. Somebody, thank you, Michael. £5. Carrie, £6. Anybody else? £6. £6. £6. Come on. Raise your hand. £6. This is chauffeuring to and from an airport. £6. Is that all it's worth to anybody? £7. Thank you, Michael. Come on, more than £7. Going. Gone.
I'm really pleased to have the chance to wish you all a very happy new year. I'm not here in person because of all the new things that God's been doing in my life over the last year, but you've been part of my life for the last 40 years. And I just thank God for the times we've shared, happy times and sad times as well. But all the best for 2009, and you watch out for the things, new things God might do for you. Bye.